Happy New Year untuk saudara kalau yang this is your first Sunday back at church after long holiday. Happy New Year. Before we go into the sermon today, can I invite you to stand and just give, I invite you back to your feet, saudara. Boleh kita bangkit berdiri and just give a hug to one or two people and just give, send blessing, saudara, and blessing in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's hug somebody and tell them that they are loved, that they are blessed, that you are proud of them. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You may be seated after that. Hari ini, I want to talk. Saya ingin melanjutkan dari visi tahun 2024, saudara. The whole year, in fact, we're gonna discuss a lot about this one subject: to prosper in all things. That's the vision for our church in 2024: to prosper, amen, in all things. For you who wanna experience that, will you say amen? Amen. To those who say amen, you are prosperous this year. To the rest, the Lord is waiting. Amen. I'm just joking. Now, setengah dari yang saya bagikan hari ini, I have shared in the class, in one of the seminar, Power to Get Wealth, saudara. But Pastor Julian encourages me a few times to share this at the church. So I decided I want to share it today. Okay, so to prosper in all things, saudara, to prosper in all things, the Lord want to prosper us in our relationship, amen? The want to prosper us in our family, amen, in our workplace, want to bless us and prosper us in our ministry, amen, but also in our finance. I want to start here in our finance because seringkali this is a misconception about prosperity. Last week I told you, you might have heard about prosperity gospel and that they use the word prosperity in a negative connotation that I believe is not from the Lord, because in the Bible, when the name of the Lord and prosper is in one verse, it's always good thing. Amen. Kata prosper yang jelek di dalam firman Tuhan ketika kata wicked sama prosper ada di dalam ayat yang sama. Karena artinya mereka devising, merencanakan evil plans, katanya. Okay, so prosperity that is from the Lord is good. Okay, prosperity that devising evil plan, that is bad, saudara. Amen. So today we continue, saudara. Saya mau memulai dari Deuteronomy, saudara, ulangan yang ke-18 ayat yang ke-8, saudara. Amen. You shall remember, amen. You shall remember the Lord your God. For it is He who gives you power to get wealth, that He may confirm His covenant that He swore to your fathers as unto this day. Haruslah engkau ingat kepada Tuhan Allahmu, sebab Dialah yang memberikan kepadamu kekuatan untuk memperoleh kekayaan, dengan maksud meneguhkan perjanjian yang diikrarkannya dengan sumpah kepada nenek moyangmu, yaitu Abraham, Ishak, dan Yakub, seperti sekarang ini. Oke? Untuk Tuhan mengkonfirmasi dan meneguhkan perjanjiannya kepada Abraham, Ishak, dan Yakub, Dia memberikan kepada orang Israel kekuatan untuk mendapatkan kekayaan. Can you imagine that? For Him to confirm His covenant to the forefathers, He give them power to get wealth. Okay, karena ini live service. Boleh kembali ke wajah saya sesaat. If wealth is bad, saudara, Dan kalau wealth itu sesuatu yang buruk, saudara, maka Tuhan memberikan kuasa kepada orang Israel untuk mendapatkan sesuatu yang buruk. Am I correct? Karena dia give Israelite, saudara, orang Israel pada saat itu power to get wealth. Kalau wealth is wrong, saudara, if there is something wrong with wealth, then God has given the Israelite something that is bad. Power to get wealth. So obviously, saudara, is not the wealth, saudara. But wealth is not something that is bad. Karena Tuhan memberikan orang Israel bukan wealth, tapi memberikan mereka power to get wealth. Artinya apa? It is more powerful. When you get wealth, you can lose it. Tapi when you have the power to get wealth, you, even if you lose your wealth, you can still get it back. Because you have the power to get wealth, saudara. Jadi untuk saudara yang mungkin saudara melakukan sebuah bisnis atau pekerjaan, ada sesuatu yang terjadi dalam kehidupan saudara. Maybe it's the pandemic, maybe it's the recession. Saudara mengalami kehilangan wealth untuk sesaat. I want you to know bahwa do not give up, saudara. Bahwa I want you to still believe in the Lord, saudara. Because you have to understand bahwa it is the wealth is not the ultimate blessing. Even if you lose that, you are blessed. You have the power to get wealth in the name of Jesus. Boleh kita beri kemuliaan kepada Tuhan. So prosperity gospel, saudara, is a term that is a bit weird for me, saudara, because the word of God, even health and wealth gospel, ada yang bilang is also used in a bad term, health and wealth gospel, dalam konotasi yang buruk. Sedangkan Tuhan yang berkata bahwa I will give you power to get well. Saudara perhatikan di Keluaran 32, saudara, ketika orang Mesir, kita belajar dulu, and then sekitar di tengah khotbah ini I want to share my heart a lot, saudara. Tapi saya mau baca, I want us to learn together saat ini. Ketika orang Israel keluar dari Mesir, Tuhan berkata demikian, katakanlah kepada bangsa itu, supaya setiap laki-laki meminta barang-barang emas dan perak kepada tetangganya. Dan setiap perempuan juga meminta yang sama ya kepada tetangganya pula. Lalu Tuhan membuat orang Mesir bermurah hati terhadap bangsa itu. Amen. Ini kata Tuhan kepada orang Israel pada saat itu, bukan kepada kita. Amen. Jadi jangan minta tetangga kita emas dan perak. Amen. Pada saat itu dia meminta, saudara, kenapa? It was righteous, saudara. It was good. Karena orang Israel diperbudak selama 400 tahun. Jadi ketika mereka mau keluar ke Mesir, Tuhan membuat orang Mesir memindahkan harta mereka kepada orang Israel. Sebetulnya adalah sebuah pembayaran, saudara. Pembayaran hasil kerja mereka for hundreds of years, oke? Okay? The Lord is just. Kalau saudara dibohongi oleh orang, kalau saudara diambil sesuatu oleh orang lain, do not worry. Tuhan udah catat, saudara. Orang Israel, saudara, menjadi budak selama 400 tahun. Tapi sebelum mereka keluar, kekayaan orang Mesir dipindahkan ke orang Israel. Because they have to pay for the work that they have done for 400 years. God will not let you be shortchanged. Amen? Tuhan akan membantu saudara in the name of Jesus. So, artinya ketika Tuhan memberikan gold, saudara, mereka mendapatkan gold dan silver, saudara. Lalu mereka berjalan di padang gurun. Satu hari Musa, saudara, sedang berdoa tapi makan waktu begitu lama. 40 hari, 40 malam Musa berdoa, saudara. Karena dia berdoa terlalu lama, orang-orang Israel bilang Tuhan tidak ada lagi bersama dengan kita. Karena kita gak bisa lihat Musa. Kita ditinggalkan oleh Tuhan, saudara. Akhirnya mereka berencana untuk membuat sebuah allah bagi mereka sendiri, yaitu lembu emas, saudara. Amen. Karena pada saat itu tahun lembu emas, bukan tahun naga kayu, saudara. Di Keluaran 32, saudara, Harun berkata kepada orang Israel, berikanlah anting-anting emas kalian kepadaku. Jawab Harun. Mereka semua menurut, laki-laki dan perempuan, dewasa maupun anak-anak, saudara. Harun melebur, that's why parents, if you bring your children to the church is a good thing. Okay? Children are influenced by their parents. Okay? To the good or to the bad. Okay? Mereka waktu melebur emas untuk bikin lembu emas, children ikutan, saudara. Okay? So if you bring your children to the church, they will be blessed as well. Oke, lanjut. Maupun anak-anak, Harun melebur emas itu dan menuang serta memahat patung seekor anak lembu. Orang-orang itu berkata, "Hai Israel, inilah Allah yang telah membuat membawa kamu keluar dari Mesir. Behold, this is your God." Dengan apa? Dengan anting-anting emas mereka buat lembu emas. So gold is bad. Am I correct? Artinya gold is not good because gold saudara membuat mereka menyembah berhala. Am I correct? Of course not, saudara. Saudara perhatikan. Setelah Tuhan menghukum 3.000 orang pada saat itu. Okay? Because they were under the law. They were condemnation. Tapi setelah itu sebetulnya Musa membawa apa sih turun dari gunung? Blueprint untuk membangun bait Allah yang Tuhan ingin bangun. Tabernacle. Next. Ketika Musa turun, akhirnya Musa meminta persembahan untuk membangun bait Allah. Karena diminta oleh Tuhan. Next. Orang-orang yang hatinya tergerak dan yang jiwanya tergugah oleh roh Allah, mereka datang untuk membawakan persembahan mereka berupa bahan-bahan untuk apa? Untuk kemah suci. Mereka membawa kepada Tuhan persembahan mereka berupa apa? Berupa emas, berupa perhiasan, yaitu anting-anting, cincin, kalung, dan macam-macam benda dari emas. Biarkan ini ayatnya sesaat di sini, saudara. Jadi emas tadi mereka memberikan apa untuk lembu emas? Memberikan anting-anting emas. Di sini mereka juga memberikan bahan-bahan emas. Mereka termasuk anting-anting yang sama. Jadi anting emas yang sama dapat digunakan untuk membangun lembu emas. Tapi anting emas yang sama juga dapat digunakan untuk membangun kemah suci atau rumah Tuhan. It is never about the gold. Is about the heart behind the gold. Amen. So jadi yang buruk is not about prospering. Is the selfishness of the heart, saudara. So it is not, is it go, is riches good or bad? Riches is riches. Your heart, saudara. Itu yang akan menentukan how the gold is being used. The same gold yang mereka pakai untuk menjadi lembu emas, mereka pakai di sini untuk bangun kemah suci, saudara. So it's not the gold, it's the heart behind gold. Wealth itself is not good. It's salah, saudara. Wealth itself is not bad. Amen. Waktu satu hari Tuhan lagi bilang bahwa ada orang kaya yang susah banget percaya sama Yesus. Murid-muridnya bilang, "Wah, it is so hard for the rich to get into heaven," muridnya bilang. Yesus betulin mereka. Yesus benarkan mereka. Do you know the verse? Yesus bilang begini, "Those who trust in riches is hard to get in." So it's not about the riches, it's about your faith and your heart toward riches. Boleh kita beri kemuliaan kepada Tuhan. Amen. We're studying, ya. We study. You know why? You know why we study? Because this year you're gonna learn so much about this thing, saudara. By the end of this year, if somebody talk to you about prosperity gospel, saudara, you will smack them in the head and you will preach to them. Amen. I'm just joking. We don't do that, saudara. But you can kick them, saudara. Okay. Now, one day Tuhan menjelaskan kepada saya. I was studying and I have a question in my heart. And then the Lord taught me something, saudara. Ketika orang Israel keluar dari Mesir, I have a question actually. Ketika orang Israel keluar dari Mesir, Tuhan berkata, biar setiap lelaki meminta barang emas kepada tetangganya, setiap perempuan meminta emas juga kepada tetangganya, lalu Tuhan membuat orang Mesir bermurah hati terhadap bangsa itu. Kenapa? Karena emas itu jadi milik siapa? Jadi milik bangsa itu, jadi milik orang Israel. Oke? Okay? Artinya Tuhan menggugahkan hati orang Mesir untuk memberikan emas kepada orang Israel. Next. Ketika Tuhan ingin membangun bait suci, next. Ketika Tuhan ingin membangun bait suci, Tuhan meminta, dia berkata kepada Musa untuk meminta emas dari orang Israel. Setiap orang yang terdorong hatinya harus membawa sebagai persembahan. Kalau engkau have a willing heart, you can bring your offering to the Lord. Oke, okay, kepada Tuhan, emas, perak, tembaga, dan lain-lain, saudara. So, saudara, next, saudara bisa lihat the flow. This is where I got confused. Tuhan menggerakkan hati orang Mesir untuk memberikan kekayaan kepada orang Israel. Lalu orang Israel baru membawakan dengan hati yang ready, dengan willing heart untuk membangun rumah Tuhan. My question is, saudara, kepada Tuhan, karena saudara, because I built the church for the past 20 years, bahwa it is often hard to get money from people's bank account. So saya bilang sama Tuhan, why don't you? Kenapa Tuhan gak bilang sama orang orang Israel, kamu ambil emas dari orang Mesir, tapi itu bukan milik kamu. I will curse you if you use it because it's all mine. Jadi mereka cuman bantu megangin aja untuk Tuhan. Can God do that? Of course. Kenapa? Karena they were broke, ya kan? Mereka enggak ada uang. Emas ini bukan milik mereka anyway. Tapi kenapa Tuhan pindahkan emasnya ke mereka terlebih dahulu? Lalu ketika Tuhan ingin bangun rumah Tuhan, Tuhan harus dalam tanda kutip meminta persembahan, saudara. You know why? Because it is never about the gold. Tapi yang Tuhan, it is never even about the house of God. It is always about the willing heart, saudara. Bukan God does not need the gold. Kalau Tuhan need the gold, Tuhan bisa bilang seperti ini. Kamu kumpulkan emas dari orang Mesir, tapi kamu harus kumpulkan sejumlah emas untuk kemah suci juga pada saat itu, oke? Okay? No. Tuhan taruh semua emasnya di tangan kamu. Oh, it's yours. Lalu saudara, Tuhan minta, would you give me for my house? But it is already yours. Artinya for you to give, you have to give something that is yours. And it needs a willing heart. And that willing heart is what God desires, saudara. Itu yang Tuhan inginkan, saudara. God is not about the gold, it's about the willing heart, saudara. Oleh karena itu, saudara, hari ini, saudara, the Lord wanna bless you. Okay? The Lord will bless the house of God through you. God will put the gold not in my hands as a pastor, but in my hands as kings. Amen. Amen. But the Lord will want to put the gold in your hands, saudara. In the name of Jesus. You know why? Because it is the willing heart that the Lord desires. Saudara tahu gak? Kita boleh buka ayat dari slide terakhir, Valen, dari slide terakhir. Ada satu kali di dalam firman Tuhan, it only happened once, maybe twice dengan janda itu, tapi sekali ini yang jelas, saudara. Musa memerintahkan supaya dimaklumkan di mana-mana di perkemahan itu. Dia berkata tidak usah ada lagi orang laki ataupun perempuan untuk membuat sesuatu menjadi persembahan bagi tempat kudus. Demikianlah rakyat itu dicegah untuk membawa persembahan. Sebab bahan yang diperlukan mereka telah cukup untuk melakukan pekerjaan itu, bahkan berlebih. Saudara, there is only one time di dalam firman Tuhan. I think this really please God's heart. Sampai mereka harus dicegah, udah jangan bawa persembahan lagi. It is enough because semua orang Israel pada saat itu, they really have a willing heart, saudara. I think this shook God's heart. I pray, bahwa in our church satu kali, saudara, by the grace of God, amen. I will forbid you. Hallelujah. This is my prayer. Satu hari I will forbid you. Koisek, please don't send any more tithing to here. Tithe harus ya lah ya. Tithe boleh. Don't give any more offering. You know why? Give it to the poor. You know why? The church has too much. Too much money. The bank keep calling me. It's too much. Too much zero. Hallelujah. Basically itu yang terjadi di dalam zaman Musa, saudara. Mereka dicegah untuk bawa persembahan. You know what? It's not about the gold. But I think God's heart was pleased. Dia bilang, they really want to give to my house. And that what it's all about. And that is wealth, saudara. In the name of Jesus. Boleh kita beri kemuliaan kepada Tuhan? Haleluya. Dari beginning, saudara, dari awal, it has always been like that. Dari Tuhan panggil Abraham, Tuhan bilang demikian, I will bless you, and you shall be a blessing. And in you, all the families of the earth will be blessed. Saya ulangi. I will bless you. Kenapa Tuhan gak langsung bless, gak usah pakai you, gak usah pakai kita. But Seperti dia menempatkan emas kepada orang Israel dulu, is the same thing. Tuhan bilang, I will bless you. And you shall be a blessing. So it's up to you in two things. Number one, will you be blessed? If not, there's no blessing to others. Number one. Kedua, do you have the heart to be a blessing to others? Dua heart itu yang akan menentukan apakah all the families of the earth akan diberkati. I will bless you and you shall be a blessing. And in you, all the families of the earth. Semua keluarga di muka bumi akan diberkati. So I want to share my heart, okay? It's going to be like a mission conference sebentar lagi. Amen. Saudara tahu gak bahwa, why do you need to be? Why prosper? Why when I speak about prosper, how I don't agree with the prosperity gospel menjadi suatu yang negatif, kenapa saya bicara dengan begitu? On fire. Do you know how many, saudara tahu gak ada sekitar 640 ribu desa di India. Kita bicara satu negara aja, India. Sekitar ada 640 ribu desa di India. Ada 500 desa di India, belum ada gereja satupun. Tidak ada Injil, tidak ada misionaris di 500 ribu gereja. Di 500 ribu desa. Untuk mengirimkan seorang misionaris ke satu desa di India, dan untuk menempatkan misionaris itu untuk 10 sampai 20 tahun akan makan waktu yang lama karena mereka hardcore other religion, saudara. Now you have to put, you have to pay a mission organization, harus bayar satu pribadi untuk 10 sampai 20 tahun untuk membangun sampai gereja itu, sampai area itu bisa diberkati, ada 500 ribu. Do you know that how much money will it take? It takes tens to hundreds of billions of dollars to support 500,000 or more families, missionary, to be sent to 500,000 villages. Nah saat ini, Christian organization can only send little by little. Sedikit demi sedikit, kirim ke 50, kirim ke 100. You know why? No money. One of the reason, do you know why? No money. Now you tell me, why is it urgent untuk saudara diberkati? You know why? Because God will put the money in your hand first. And then you shall be a blessing to other people, to these villages, to this unreached people group. Tuhan gak akan langsung taruh uang di situ. He will give you first. I don't know why God does this. That's why when I ponder about the house of God, that's why I ask God, kenapa Tuhan gak bilang aja udah orang Israel ini daripada mereka pelit ya. Saya kasih kamu segini, itu gak, bukan kamu punya semua ya. If God says that, it's easier. Tapi God took a risk. Dia taruh emasnya semua buat orang Israel. I will ask for you with a willing heart later. God took a risk on us. That first, we believe that he will bless us. And second, that we will want to be a blessing. Dan saudara, 500 ribu village itu, kita kembali ke situ. You need tens and hundreds of billions of dollars. Who are going to give them? All this mission organization, it's us, it's Christians, saudara. Jadi there is no other option, saudara, untuk saudara, than to be blessed. For you to be blessed, there is no other option. It is urgent, it is needed, it is desperate, saudara. Because people are dying without Jesus. And we need what? The church needs, the body of Christ all over the world needs money. Saudara lihat, ada sebuah seorang billionaire di US, saudara, memakai sebuah toilet next. It's a golden toilet. Maybe you have heard of this before, have you? There's a billionaire di US, saudara. Dia memakai golden toilet to take a poo. So much waste. While the church says, it's prosperity gospel, we don't need it. It's not for us. By the grace of God, when we have those kind of money, it is not for golden toilet. Amen. Mungkin some of you have a vision for golden toilet. Amen. So much waste. So much money in the world. And gold is not bad. But some people will use their gold for the toilet. Well, some people, we use the gold to build the temple or to bless the poor. Satu hari saya about to go out, and because saya ada sponsor kepada World Vision, saya melihat sebuah, saya baca-baca sebuah majalah dari mereka. Lalu saya lihat gambar ini. Next. I saw this. By the way, World Vision is a Christian organization. When I saw this, saya batal pergi. Saya bilang sama Christy, kita batal pergi. I was crying. I remember this, but maybe 15 years ago, I was crying. And I told God, God, ada orang-orang tuh yang lagi poopnya di golden toilet. Ada orang-orang yang, ada anak-anak kecil yang, if this is your children, if this is your child, Albert Harjo, if this is your child, would this break your heart? This is God's child. It broke God's heart. It still breaks his heart. Do you think if you ask from God, I need wealth so there can be a blessing for these kind of children, will he not give you? He will give you more and even more than enough. Because this is not about us. This is what I'm talking about when I talk about prosperity. It's not just a prosperity for my 10th car. It is about a prosperity with a purpose. There's so many people are in need. Saudara, ada sebuah ayat di mana ada 5,000 orang lelaki dengan keluarganya enggak bisa makan. Katanya Jesus had compassion on them. Oke, ayatnya gitu dimulainya. Jesus had compassion on them. Lalu Yesus bilang apa? Next. And he said to the disciple, you give them something to eat. They said we have no more than 5 loaves and 2 fish. There were about 5,000 men. Saudara perhatikan di situ. This is the principle repeated again. Yesus bilang, you give them something to eat. I don't know why that God trust us so much. Bahwa setelah Tuhan menciptakan bumi dan langit, it is done. God always partner with people to do great things on the earth, saudara. If I'm God, I would not do that. Because I'm afraid they will keep the gold. Because I'm afraid they cannot be trusted. But God choose to trust. And he say, Abraham, I will give you blessing. I will bless you. So that you can be a blessing. So it is up to us, church. To be blessed, it is up to us. To believe, it is up to us. There is no other option, Zach, you understand? For you then to be very, very wealthy, because the money is not going to just go straight to the child yang tadi minum di situ. It's going to be through somebody, and it's going to be through you, the descendant of Abraham. You understand that? That's why we need to be blessed. That's why all this prosperity gospel in negativity nonsense is nonsense, saudara. That we are desperate, saudara, to be blessed. Saudara, ada seorang, there is this boat. Ini adalah a 300 feet yacht. Wow. Who wanna have this yacht? You can, it's okay, saudara. Walaupun khotbah lagi becoming a blessing, you can if you want. By the grace of God, saudara, this yacht, or a yacht like this, 300 feet yacht, is owned by a billionaire. Then he said, I have never even set foot on my yacht. Saya bahkan gak pernah injak kapal yang saya beli. There's a Russian oligarch yang berkata, I have 2 yachts. I don't even know where they are. I want you to know, church, there's so much money, and it's been used for yacht that is not even being set, yang bahkan gak dipakai sama mereka. You understand? Sedangkan saudara, one day aku ada di mission conference, this breaks my heart and I think it breaks everyone's heart in the mission conference. Dia lagi bilang, dia pleading, dia bilang ada satu tribe, ada satu suku di Tibet, satu suku di Tibet, unreached people group, gak kenal Yesus semuanya. Dan sampai sekarang belum kenal pada saat itu. Kenapa? Karena to reach that specific group, we need not a helicopter, we need a military helicopter. We need a military helicopter. Tapi we don't have it. The church don't have it. The body of Christ don't have it. It's hundreds of millions of dollars. I feel when that breaks my heart pada saat itu, and breaks everyone's heart. When God heard that, ketika Tuhan dengar itu, you don't have what? I give my son. I died. You can believe for military helicopter because I love the tribe in Tibet too. Saudara, next kita lihat ayat ini. Kalau dari antara kamu yang punya 100 ekor domba, jikalau ia kehilangan seekor di antaranya, siapa yang enggak tinggalkan 99 ekor di padang gurun dan pergi mencari yang sesat itu sampai ia ketemu? As for God, dia punya komitmen untuk ketemu apapun yang dibutuhkan. This is God, okay? I have a commitment to find the lost son and the lost sheep no matter whatever it takes. Akankah Tuhan tahan the money to buy a military helicopter? Kalau begitu, oh Tuhan tahan, kenapa? It's prosperity gospel. I want to tell you bahwa Tuhan gak mungkin tahan. Tahu gak kenapa military helicopter mission organization kan uangnya juga flowing banyak ya untuk kirim ke banyak-banyak ini. I sit in those meetings back then. In some of the big ones I joined. Tahu gak kenapa? I tell you why. Karena waktu meeting, at the end of the day kan ada annual report. Harus tanggung jawab kan. Harus tanggung jawab kepada orang-orang yang memberi kan. Jadi mereka pasti pakai uangnya harus wise. Gak mungkin beli 200 juta dolar hanya untuk satu suku. Gak mungkin dong. Kenapa gak pakai 200 juta ini untuk jangkau 5.000 desa? Which is wiser in human, pasti ya wiser. Jadi mission organization gak ada yang berani beli military helicopter. Gak mungkin berani beli, karena it's unwise. Siapa di sini yang punya anaknya dua? Albert, kalau kamu punya dua anak, yang satu hilang, satu enggak. Dua-duanya hilang, kamu bisa pilih enggak yang hilang yang mana? Kalau yang satu biayanya lebih mahal, kamu rela enggak yang lebih mahal hilang? Enggak bisa. Kita enggak bakal bisa pilih. Dan untuk Tuhan yang sangat susah dijangkau di suku di Tibet walaupun butuh ratusan juta dolar, sama orang yang gampang dijangkau karena dia cuma ada di desa di samping rumah, for God is the same, it all broke his heart. Dia bilang, why don't you ask for all? Why don't you ask? Dan saat ini mission organization, the hands are locked, mereka gak bakal bisa beli. We need businessmen who have the money to buy it themselves, saudara, untuk buy it themselves, karena if this is your money, Chong, nobody gonna say no to you. If they say why you use that money, you shut up, it's my money. You understand? So I want you to know bahwa it is desperate, Tamrin. It is urgent, Amites. It is needed, Ko Isaac, for you to be blessed with so much more in the name of Jesus. Boleh kita beri kemuliaan kepada Tuhan. I'm not angry at you, by the way. I'm just passionate. If I talk about mission, saudara, my heart is there, saudara. Hallelujah. Satu hari, Pastor Bill Hybel lagi buang sampah, orang bule kan buang sampah sendiri ya. Kalau kita gak bisa relate dengan ini, kita bawa tong sampah. Dia lagi buang, ada stiker yang dia juga lagi buang. Di situ gambar apa? Ternyata ada gambar dua anak kecil yang lagi hilang. Tau kan biasa kalau di bule kan selalu kasih dalam milk karton atau kayak selembaran ya. Dia ya cuman karena lihat dia buang, karena dia gak pernah lihat anak itu juga dia buang. Terus Tuhan stop dia. Dia bilang, pick that up again. Dia ambil. You see these parents. Yang anaknya di, sadly di negara Europe sering kali terjadi ya. Ada anak-anak hilang ya for apa trafficking, human trafficking. Dia bilang, the parent akan go door to door, akan kosongkan bank account-nya, dan mungkin sudah, untuk cari dua anak. Because that's how a parent thinks. Because that's the heart of the parent. And for my children, no matter how much money you need, I will give. No matter how much blessing you need, I will give. For my lost children, saya gak akan tahan anything. Oleh karena itu ayatnya seperti ini. Next. He who did not spare his own son. Kalau dia gak menyayangkan anaknya, but gave him up for us all. Dia kasih anaknya buat kita. How will he not? Bagaimana mungkin dia along with him gak berikan, give us all things. Bagaimana mungkin dia gak berikan segalanya. Kalau dia udah kasih Yesus loh, dia udah kasih anaknya. Sekarang Tuhan untuk kita jadi berkat, we need 100 million rupiah misalnya. Oh, prosperity gospel. Jangan. Nanti jangan ya. This is wealth and health gospel. Don't. I don't want to give you that. Who teach that? Tuhan bilang, if I have given you my son, I will give you all things in him. Hallelujah. Itu one waktu kecil, cute ya Ci ya. Cute ya, saya lihat cute. Cici, saya tahu ceritanya nih. Pernah dong waktu kerja keras untuk sekolahin, belum so prosperous seperti sekarang. Pernah kasih banyak mungkin uang-uang yang berharga tapi demi anak dikasih. Pernah, Ci?
Yeah.
You will give. There will be no objection. I believe for parents here, you will starve. Yeah? If you need to give your children food, you will starve. Kalau perlu kamu yang kelaparan. Di seluruh dunia, this is a mission conference for you. This is not every week we do this, but I hope that you are blessed today. But saya boleh panggil Acong, Ferry, boleh panggil ke depan sebentar. Ketika Tuhan mencium gerejanya seperti Acong dengan Ferry. When they kiss. Boleh berbaris. Ada 5,5 miliar orang di muka bumi yang belum mengenal Kristus. Banyak di antaranya, miliaran di antaranya ada di tempat-tempat yang namanya unreached people group. Memang tidak ada Injil, enggak kayak di Jakarta, di mana-mana gereja. Ada banyak tempat yang they cannot even hear the word of God. Okay. Nah ketika 5,5 miliar itu seberapa banyak sih? 5.5 billion, how big is that number? Kalau kita bariskan 5,5 miliar orang, kaki nempel ke kaki, boleh nempel kak? Boleh peluk kalau bingung takut jatuh, boleh peluk. Ini namanya 1 feet, sekitar 26 cm itu 1 feet ya. Kecuali kakinya Ferry mungkin 36 cm ini. Tapi saudara kalau kita bariskan 5,5 miliar orang yang belum kenal Yesus. Dari Jakarta, dari tengahnya bumi, berarti mungkin sekitar Kalimantan nih kali ya. Mungkin ya, Katulistiwa ya. Kita berbaris seperti ini, 5,5 miliar orang. Percaya enggak saudara akan nyampe ke Afrika kalau ada jembatan. Sebanyak itu. Bahkan akan nyampe ke South America. Percaya enggak? Nyampe ke setengah bumi loh. Kalau ada jembatan bahkan akan muter sampai lagi ke sini saudara. That's how much 5,5 miliar orang. More than that. 3 kali mengelilingi bumi. Kalau kita baris. Ini adalah barisan kedua. Barisan ketiga. Tahu gak berapa kali kira-kira muterin bumi? 5,5 miliar orang. 10 kali? More. 20 times? More. 30 times? 42 times. Akan ada 42 baris menempel feet to feet mengelilingi bumi 5,5 miliar orang. Orang yang belum percaya dengan Yesus. Do you know how much money it takes to reach every single one of them. How many church does it needed? Do you know how many missionaries does it need? Yet the church say, we don't believe in prosperity. On contrary, the church need to be blessed so much more, so that we can bless, so that we can help. There's a mother here. There's a father here. This is not a father yet, but soon. There's a father here. There's a teenager. And people are going. Mereka sedang berbaris not knowing Jesus. Mereka sedang berbaris to eternity without Jesus. And we are being entrusted oleh Tuhan. Makanya saya kadang bertanya, why? Boleh duduk dulu, silakan. Tapi berciuman dulu seperti Kristus dengan gerejanya. Disitulah saya bertanya sama Tuhan, why do you put the wealth in Israel hands? Dan nanti kan gak ngeri, mereka gak akan bangun rumah Tuhan. Kenapa Tuhan bilang diberkati Abraham dulu baru jadi berkat? I don't know why. But God in His infinite wisdom chose to trust you. Dia bilang, I will bless you if you wanna believe it. And I will make you a blessing. Siapa di sini yang will cry out to God? Yang bilang sama Tuhan, God, bless me. God, bless me. It will be selfish if you don't pray that. Let me just, okay, that's a mind changing. Karena kalau orang yang bilang, oh, God, udah cukup. Okay, kalau kamu cukup segini. I want, sekarang kamu hidup segini aja. Still use your talent to gain more. And give the rest for the Lord. Kan bisa, saudara. Okay? It will be selfish kalau kita bilang sama Tuhan, saya udah cukup, I don't need more. But many people need more. Boleh saya lihat? I want to tell you, church. Hallelujah. Are you okay, guys? I hope you're okay. Now, ada seorang yang mendengarkan mission conference yang sama dengan saya pada saat itu oleh Pastor Larry Stockdale. I love that pastor. He's a missionary and a pastor as well. Bukan yang ini ya. Kreatif tapi salah gak apa-apa, Valen. I love you. Dia bilang dulu ada seorang namanya Reinhard Bonnke. Zaman saya is very famous. Dia berkhotbah hanya di Afrika. Hanya di Afrika. Pada umumnya dia berkhotbah di depan mungkin 1 sampai 1,5 juta orang. Okay. Yang menerima Yesus banyak sekali. I think he one of the father yang membawa Afrika kepada Yesus in our generation. Pastor Larry Stockdale bilang tentunya crusade seperti ini makan duit. Pada saat itu, it takes $1 million, one event. For 3 days, $1 million. Oleh karena itu event seperti ini diadakannya gak bisa setiap bulan. Diadakannya biasa ada jarak, lalu diadakan lagi. Ada jarak, kenapa? It needs a lot of money, a lot of resources. Ada seorang anak muda di situ yang lagi duduk, dia bilang sama Tuhan, God, I want $1 million. I want to bless him for $1 million. I want to make one crusade with my money. Singkat cerita, dia lagi kerja, bosnya bilang, there is one impossible project yang kita sedang kerjakan. Okay. Kalau ada yang di antara kalian bisa solve this project and sell this project, I will give you $1 to $2 million bonus. Lalu dia bilang, I will do it. I will do it and I definitely I will make it happen. Kata the boss say, no, it's impossible. Tapi dia bilang, I will do it. I think he sold the project to, by the way, this specific project to JP Morgan, I think. Tapi singkat cerita 2-3 bulan kemudian dia berhasil dan dia dapat cek $1 juta. $1 million, dia minta exactly $1 million. Lalu dia pergi ke Pastor Larry Stockdale pada saat itu. Dia bilang gini, Pastor, remember you told me that Reverend Reinhardt buat satu acara for 1 million people, take $1 million. This is a check for $1 million. Take it and give it to Reverend Reinhardt. Lalu Reinhardt Bonnke buat satu acara. Satu acara itu dia buat dengan uang ini doang, satu orang. Tahu gak berapa orang? Dulu kan saudara yang tahu, zaman dulu kita kalau ke KKR kita selalu dapat surat yang bilang mau terima Yesus apa enggak, tik. Ingat ya, ini zaman dulu nih, zaman kita. Tik, mau terima Yesus. 1,1 juta orang yang tik, saya mau terima Yesus. Dengan $1,000,000 yang dia kasih. So I want to challenge you, church. God desperately want to give. You shall be blessed. And then you will be a blessing. It is not about Lord, give me, give me, give me. Kalau saudara, kalau kita punya mentalitas give me, give me, give me, kita akan cuman happy 2 kali setahun. Ulang tahun dan Christmas. Tapi kalau hati kita adalah Lord, give me, give me, give me, so that I can bless and bless and bless and bless and bless. You can be happy 365 days a year, saudara. Because you can always give to the people surrounding you. From your wife to your parents, to your children, to your neighbor, to your church, to the poor. You can always give, saudara. Dan kalau saudara yang you have been blessed with money, you know. That it is the true joy. Your new car, untuk saudara yang melihat orang tua saudara misalnya kerja keras, waktu saudara punya uang, your new car gak akan membuat saudara lebih senang daripada when you retire your parents. You is incomparable. Saudara gak bisa compare rasa bahagianya saudara when you give and become a blessing. Oleh karena itu Tuhan bilang, it is more blessed to give than to receive. But for you to give, you need to first receive, saudara, from the Lord, saudara. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Nanti saudara akan terima ini. Ini anak ini namanya Arleth, dari Compassion saya memberikan sponsorship untuk memberi makan seorang anak seperti ini. You have seen Compassion before, right? Yeah. Memberi makan, memberi biaya sekolah, memberi baju, tau gak berapa? Sebulan $40. $40, my God, so cheap. Many of our lunch today, or our dinner today, will cost more than $40. That $40 will give them school, will give them food, will give them clothes, will give them food for a whole month. So the question remain, kan? Tuhan, kalau ada banyak anak seperti ini, kenapa Tuhan pilih kami? Why don't you just give them? Udahlah, gak usah melalui orang karena I don't know why. Tapi waktu Tuhan lihat Tamrin, Tuhan bilang, Tamrin, I will bless you. I will not langsung lewat. I will bless you. And you shall be a blessing. I don't know why. Waktu Tuhan lihat Shandy, dia bilang, I will give it to your hand. If you can believe it, minta dari orang Mesir emas dan perak. One day nanti aku akan minta. If you have a willing heart. So church, saya mau impart hati ini kepada saudara. Bahwa prosperity is from the Lord. Wealth is from God. And there is no other option than the body of Christ, than you. Untuk minta dan to be blessed, you need to ask from the Lord so that you can be so much a blessing. Ada seorang anak muda, satu hari dia melihat korban perang. Dia menangis, kalau gak salah dia di Korea pada saat itu, kalau gak salah perang di Korea. Dia berlutut, lalu dia berdoa demikian. Lord, let my heart be broken by the things that break the heart of God. Lord, let my heart be broken by the things that break the heart of God. Yang doa ini namanya Bob Pierce. Orang ini berdoa yang besar. Tahu gak siapa Bob Pierce? Boleh lihat World Vision. Bob Pierce adalah pendiri daripada World Vision. World Vision setiap tahunnya mengalirkan dana sekitar 1,5 sampai 3 billion dollar every year. Telah memberikan makan anak-anak kecil seperti ini lebih dari 200 juta anak. Lebih dari 200 juta anak selama beberapa puluh tahun terakhir telah diberkati, disekolahkan, diberikan makan. World Vision. Hanya karena siapa? Hanya karena ada satu orang yang bilang sama Tuhan, give me the money. Bless me. So that I can become a blessing. Hampir seluruh cerita yang kita dengar ini, Red Cross dibuka oleh siapa? Orang Kristen. Salvation Army dibuka oleh siapa? William Booth, a missionary. World Vision oleh siapa? Christian, Bob Pierce. Compassion oleh Christian. But saudara, saya mau kasih tahu bahwa banyak kan cerita ini udah lebih dari 20 tahun lalu. There is no comparable organization now that is being built. Yet. Karena mata Tuhan. Dari mana cong ayatnya tadi mata Tuhan?
To Chronicles 16 verse 9.
2 Tawarikh 16. Mata Tuhan melihat ke seluruh bumi untuk mencari orang yang dia bisa limpahkan kekuatannya. You know, Tuhan tuh sampai nyari ke seluruh bumi untuk dia bisa limpahkan kekuatan, limpahkan kekayaan, limpahkan resources kepada orang. Agar orang itu bisa memberi, agar orang itu bisa memberkati, agar orang itu bisa membangun hal-hal yang hebat untuk Tuhan. Why do we need to be prosper? Because there is no other option, saudara. Gak ada opsi lain. Karena if the world receive the money, they might give to the poor, maybe, but they will not send missionary, right? It is up to us. It is up to the church. By the way, untuk kalau kita nanti banyak di antara saudara akan diberkati luar biasa. Jangan sampai saudara ingat ya, remember, this is not from the Lord. Kasih ke orang miskin aja, nggak usah kasih ke rumah Tuhan. It is not from the Lord. Kalau saudara lihat di dalam perjanjian lama, terutama kalau saudara lihat di dalam pembangunan, Tuhan selalu bangun bait Allah dulu, baru berkati orang miskin. Kenapa? Because when people lose the heart for God, sooner or later they will lose the heart even for the poor. Only God can keep your heart even for the poor. Oleh karena itu waktu Tuhan masuk ke sebuah kota, restore Israel, dia bangun dulu bait Allah, and then he take care of the poor, okay? Because God first. And then you will have even the heart for human being. Oke, okay. Itu intermezzo saudara. Tapi hari ini, my challenge to you church, will you ask for God to bless you? Will you ask for God? God bless me financially. Ada seorang teman saya yang berdoa begini. Dia ada di sebuah gereja, dia berdoa. My prayer is this, pastor. Saya berdoa agar my tithe, agar perpuluhan saya, bisa run the whole church. I say, so it be, brother. God bless you. A good heart. 90%-nya mau buat apa? Sisa jangan lupa 10% for a friend, a good friend, okay? I'm just joking. Tapi doa seperti itu, saya lagi lihat kehidupan dia. He's on the way to achieving that. I will tell him and I will remind him as a friend yang udah dengar doa dia 10 tahun lalu. I will come to him, remember your prayer. Don't forget for you to bless the church and run the whole church with your tithe. But he's well on the way. Sooner or later. Tuhan tuh gak takut saudara mau memberkati. God is not afraid to bless people with wealth. God is not afraid to channel billions of dollars to one man yang bernama Bob Pierce. God is not afraid with people's prayer. Justru mata Tuhan sedang mencari to and fro. Dan dia lagi tanya, who are you wanna believe that you can prosper in all things? May the Lord bless you, church. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Yang menerima boleh katakan, amen. Saya boleh panggil the worship team to come forward. Di I hope you learn something, okay, today. I hope you learn. I studied this maybe 10 or 15 years ago in a mission conference. Broke my heart. Menjadikan saya, saudara, I think I made a decision to become a pastor. Salah, harusnya saya jadi konglomerat, tapi saya kepindah jadi karena dengar khotbah ini saya jadi pastor, saudara. But it's okay, saudara, it's a calling. Beberapa tahun lalu, okay, ini sharing hati ya, kita udah mau selesai. You okay, guys? Beberapa tahun lalu, saya berdoa sama Tuhan dengan cara yang berbeda. Ada tiga pribadi di dalam perjanjian lama yang bangun rumah Tuhan. Yang pertama bernama Musa, yang kedua bernama Salomo, yang ketiga bernama Ezra. Oke, tiga pribadi. Musa membangun rumah Tuhan dengan cara minta kepada jemaat. Lalu dia bangun tabernakel. Oke, the Lord bless. Ezra membangun rumah Tuhan dengan meminta kepada satu raja. Namanya Raja Cyrus. Dikasih dana, dia bilang, dia gak usah minta sama orang lain. Langsung dikasih dana sama Raja Cyrus. Dia bangun, pokoknya enak. Kayak misionaris ya, dikirim. Oke, gak usah pikirin uang, kita yang pikirin. Gak usah ngumpulin uang, kita yang kirim. Ada satu pribadi lagi namanya Salomo. Dia gak ngumpulin uang, dia gak minta uang. Dengan kekayaan sendiri aja, dia sanggup bangun rumah Tuhan sendirian. He was so wealthy. Abis bangun rumah Tuhan, dia masih bangun rumah buat dia, masih bangun rumah buat Queen, masih berkati seluruh Israel. He was so blessed. Saya, saudara, for 15 years of my life, I've been having the anointing of Moses. Saya mengumpulkan dana, kita bangun suatu. But a few years ago, it comes to my mind. And I start praying, Lord, because you trust the man and the person. Sometimes, kita kumpulkan Tuhan, not you ya, you guys are generous. Sometimes it's hard to get gold from people's hand. Jadi saya bilang sama Tuhan, I think when I look at one of those picture, anak kecil itu, Lord, put it in my hands. I want Solomon's anointing. Bless me. I bilang, I don't want to only preach. I want to bless the church with so much money. I want to bless the mission field with so much money. I only have one sponsorship at the moment. I want to have 100 of this. I want to channel money so much in the name of Jesus. Kita lihat 10 tahun lagi gimana ya, kan belum tahu kan. It's just a prayer, right? But I want to challenge you for you to pray too. Lord, 300 feet yacht itu duitnya, daripada itu kapal gak ngapa-ngapain di tengah laut, ownernya aja gak pernah injek, pindahin ke bank saya. So that I can bless. Not so that I can have another yacht that I do not set foot upon. Bukan kayak gitu, saudara. But so that I can bless. Bless me so that I can become a blessing. That is our purpose. In the name of Jesus. Boleh kita bangkit berdiri sama-sama. As we close this mission conference. Amen. One of these day di gereja, saya udah minta Shandy to connect us with Compassion. Kita akan ada Compassion team yang datang, then we can sponsor a child. Okay. Now some of us, kita masih in debt, masih dalam hutang. Saudara, God will bless you, release you from that. Amen. Some of you cannot dream that big yet, karena saudara, your dream is for your children. God bless you. God bless you. God help you to feed and to bless your children. Some of you, your prayer is still for your parents. I want to be a blessing for my parents. I want them to quit working. I want them to can enjoy their life. They have been working for their whole life. God bless you for that too. I want you to know it's okay to have that prayer. God bless you. But what if I expand your prayer now? Now that we know that God has unlimited resources, why stop in our family? Why stop there? Why don't we ask God, you bless me even more? In the name of Jesus. So I can bless. May the Lord put hati yang baru di dalam kita. Albert, you need to pray 10 times bigger. It needs to be 10 times bigger in Jesus' name. Amen. When it is too much for you, use it for others. Train your giving muscle. Learn to give more and ask for more. I believe that God can trust your heart in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. I've had this in mind for Achong the past few days. Do not, jangan malu, do not be ashamed of being blessed. Be okay by being blessed in Jesus' name. It is okay for you to be wealthy and blessed. For the Lord knows your heart too. And you will give. And you will give again. In the name of Jesus.